Hi, and welcome to my new player's guide for Sastasha, the first dungeon in Final Fantasy XIV 2.0. To unlock this dungeon, you must be level 15 and be on It's Probably Pirates, the main story quests. Before I start the guide, I would like to mention a few must-have quests. Make sure to complete level 9, simply the Hest, located in all sea states, to unlock Guild Hest in the Duty Finder. And after completing this dungeon, make sure to do another quest called Rising to the Challenge, which unlocks the weekly challenge log. I will also list some secondary quests for notable rewards in the description below. Now that's out of the way, look forward to the dungeon guide. Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to another video of this new player guide for Final Fantasy XIV and 2020. There were a few things that I point of interest quest that I did. I'm gonna put that in the description below, and this will be our first dungeon as a tank. This will be a tank POV, so let's just go ahead and queue up for the dungeon. Hopefully it'll be fast. Okay, so we have tanks and healers get priority when it comes to queuing on these duty finder. Let's see how long this is gonna take. Since this is our first dungeon, and we only have this one option to do, might take some time. Just give it about a minute. If it doesn't queue up, I'll just cut the video and then I'll turn the video back on when I do have a queue. And the queue pops. If you're new to tanking for the first time, it's easy. It's not that difficult these days to tank, because now all your global cooldown actions, the attacks have the ability to gain hate by just making sure if you're a gladiator, you have your iron will or your defensive stance up, and you're good to go. That said, never use provoke to pull at all. Provoke is only there to give you 1 point of enmity if the mob is attacking someone else or the hate is on someone else. That's the only time you would use provoke, because it gives you that 1 point extra. And immediately, if you provoke, you have to make sure you attack the monster. Or else, if you don't, and you just use provoke, if the other party member attack the monster that you use provoke on, it will go back and have threat on them. So never use that. These are just for special cases. But if you're tanking a dungeon and you're just pulling monsters, don't use provoke, please. I've seen people use it. Even people who've played this game for a long time use provoke. Maybe it's something they like to do, I don't know. But keep that for Final Fantasy XI. It's been about 2 minutes. Nothing hasn't popped. And what else? So the rotation will be fast blade and right blade for now. And use shield up to pull. And once you pull, you can just go ahead and use total eclipse. That's what it is, total eclipse. Yeah. So something like this. And just go here. And just do this for a few. If you like to use the whole fight, you can do this if you like the whole fight. Just pull a few monsters and just keep doing this. That's what most players do. Just AoE stuff down, because there's no, like again, there's no TP to manage. So you just go ahead and use that. And here we go. anytime now. I hope that DPS click. Okay, there we go. This will be your first dungeon if you're completely new and you're tanking. Limit break? Sure, whatever. I think by now if you're a Final Fantasy fan, you know what a limit break is. Remember stance, defensive stance in this pull. You can pull just two at a time or four, but we're gonna go easy this time. Since players might be new, other players might be new. So again, you can just do totally flip the whole fight. Rather than attacking individual. Monsters. Pop your defensive cooler and just go to town. Of course, dodge any AoEs. As a matter of fact, let's get that reacquisition of XP. The healer might be new. I'm not sure if it's a new current player that decided to create a new character in the server, so I don't want to go too crazy. So what we're gonna do here is just kill this giant clam here first and then move on to the next one. These should be three of these. Normally for if there's just two or two monsters, I just go ahead and do my regular rotation. Totally clips might just be the only move for these monsters. Thank you. There is a note at the beginning of the dungeon that you can read. It gives you a hint that which of these colors will not be the trap. Fortunately, I didn't do that. It's not that bad. Of course, you get loots in these dungeons. So we're just gonna stop here. And you can pull these, but I'm not sure how skilled this hero is. You can pull these guys, the boss over here, but again, I'm not sure how experienced the healer is. This dungeon, most people don't get the achievement for it because it's huge in this area. So a lot of people don't explore most of it. For the sake of this video and the people I'm playing with, I don't want to be inconsiderate. I'm not going to explore the full dungeon, but there are other areas in this part where you can go. And get the full dungeon map for the achievement, which is here over this area here. You can do solo, I guess, whenever you're higher level. It's still great that this thing pops up like this. I should take it off, but I don't want to take it off. Blade, right blade. If you pull the clips, you can control the threat. You still have them in the rotation. they have little dogs coming out of these cages here. And a few. Just be on the lookout for them. And just totally clip them. That's a nice one. For this guy, all you need to do is just burn him down. You don't need to bother with the mechanics. Before, used to had to click on those unnatural ripples, so to prevent a backup to spawn. But now just burn this guy down if you have DPS to do so. I don't think you have the DPS. Well, it doesn't matter. It's okay. You can choose to do that, but you don't have to. If everybody just DPS this thing down. And that's it. So again, you don't need to click on those mechanics. I'm just gonna get the healer, commendation, and get the hell out of here. So that's it for Sastasha. One, two, three, right? Alright, that's it for the video. I will continue with another one when I get to the next dungeon. Peace out.